Hello everyone, Genesis Writer here, very happy to be bringing you my Tips and Tricks Ultimate Thruster Pack Guide video. This will be going over the armor ability known as Thruster Pack in Halo 4, my favorite armor ability for sure. And during part 1 of this video, we'll be going over the basics of how to use the Thruster Pack. During part 2, we'll be going over my actual in-matchmaking recorded gameplay examples where I use the Thruster Pack effectively in a specific situation. And in the third and final part of this video, we'll be going over custom game gameplay of me running around on a map alone using the Thruster Pack in unique ways for that specific map. My recommendation is that you watch this video in its entirety so that you get the full compass of events and tips and tricks, starting with the basic levels and building up to more complex ones. This is not an easy ability to use or gain comfortableness with, and I'll be going over some of my thoughts on the Thruster Pack at the end of the video. But for now, let's get started. Warning, the following clips contain infinite Thruster Pack usage. In realistic matchmaking scenarios, you will have to wait for your Thruster Pack to cool down a few seconds before using it again. Starting out with the basics, you can Thruster Pack in any direction by simply holding your movement analog stick in that direction and tapping the armor ability button. You can do it at an angle as shown here by the slow motion clip. Now moving on to a slightly more advanced tactic, you can actually Thruster Pack, and while you are Thruster Packing, move your Spartan's viewpoint so that he'll be facing a different direction when you are kicked back into the first person viewpoint. Let's view some examples of that. So right here you have four fast back-to-back examples of me turning my viewpoint while Thruster Packing. And here's a slow example. As I'm Thruster Packing, I'm simply aiming to the right, so that when I'm kicked back into first person, my Spartan is now aiming at that new location. Show you a few more examples of this again. Now this is a very important thing to understand because it allows you to be very brutal with combat at close quarters. Just to show you how effective this is, let me change my controller look sensitivity up to 10. This will allow me to turn more quickly while Thruster Packing. Essentially, you should be aware that players using high sensitivities with the Thruster Pack can react very quickly in close range combat. I am not at all suggesting that you actually change your sensitivity to 10. What I find is that sensitivity of 3 is actually a little too slow when using the Thruster Pack. As you can see here, I'm going to change my sensitivity back to 4, which is what I normally use. And you can see that when I Thruster Pack, I'm almost able to turn 180 degrees so that I'm facing someone behind me. And this is just what I find works best for me. On a little bit of a side note, you should use what sensitivity you are the most comfortable with. Most pro Halo players find their sensitivity between 3 and 5. In my personal opinion, 3 is a little bit too slow. It just doesn't allow you to react quickly to people who are behind you, or at least not quickly enough. In my personal opinion, 5 is just a tad too high, so I stick around 4, but ultimately it's your own personal preference, and you should stick with what you're most comfortable with. So how far does the Thruster Pack actually push you across the map, and how fast is it? Right here you can see that paired against a normal Spartan walking speed, the Thruster Pack gains on that speed and tops it, making me go faster than my teammate in this situation. But if we switch over to where my teammate is actually sprinting, you can see that my teammate actually gains on me while I'm using the Thruster Pack. What this means is that while the Thruster Pack is faster than a normal Spartan's walking speed, it is not faster than a sprinting speed. So you should not Thruster Pack while sprinting towards a location. For example, right here on Ragnarok, sprinting top middle for the Spartan laser, there is 0 point in Thruster Packing in the middle of doing so, because this will actually slow you down. It's not faster than your sprinting speed, and only slows you down from that. Following the same sprint versus normal movement principle, the Thruster Pack does not extend the length of jumps while sprinting. It only slightly aids in your speed during a specific section of your sprint jump. Here's an example on the map Simplex. To execute a jump to top middle from either base, all I have to do is sprint while on top of this wall and jump the last second. Notice how when this sprint jump is executed with a Thruster Pack, it only aids slightly in the speed with which the jump was performed, not the distance it covered. You can see this by the fact that regardless of whether I use my thruster pack or not, I still hit the top middle platform in about the same location, thus dispelling the myth that the thruster pack actually aids in the distance of your sprint jump. Again, following the same sprint versus normal movement principle, the thruster pack does improve the distance traveled by a normal walking jump. To prove my point, watch as my teammate stands on this line on the floor, and then jumps to the right only to land just shy of the next groove he is now standing beside. If he performs the same maneuver with the thruster pack involved, he easily covers the distance to this line that he previously fell short of. So up until this point in the video, I've clearly shown you that the thruster pack does not aid in you covering a distance more quickly from point A to point B, more than the Spartan's normal sprint does. So if sprinting supersedes the power of the thruster pack in terms of the distance covering, then how is the thruster pack actually useful and why should you use it? Well, to truly understand this, you're going to have to see me actually use thruster pack in matchmaking. But for now, I do want to go over a few other little details on how the thruster pack can be used in more advanced ways, so that when we actually do go over some matchmaking clips and when you see those advanced maneuvers pulled off in the correct way, you'll recognize them and have more appreciation for them. So let's start with an example. With a few shots and a grenade, I'm able to get a player one shot on top Mohawk, but I have to back up because my shields are weak. Now I'm going to pop out from this angle and headshot them to actually get the kill. Now, most players would go, why in the world, Genesis, did you just jump off the map? But what you have to realize is two key factors. I can redivert myself back onto the map using the thruster pack. And number two, the thruster pack is not going to jet me to the left in terms of getting me back onto the map. In other words, if I jump too far here, I would not be able to thruster pack back to the left onto the map. As it is, you can see how my thruster pack actually takes the angle that I would have fallen, in other words, a very, very steep angle, and just applies it toward a leftward movement. This is crucial to understand, so let's go over another example where this is the case. Once again, top middle on the map Haven, we're standing on one of the four main platforms. I'm going to get your eyes used to me falling off the platform normally and then jumping back onto this ledge. Now pause here for just a second. I want you to think about how the thruster pack is going to work if I thruster pack to my right off the ledge instead of just normally walking off and falling off of it like I just did. Most beginner players would think that the thruster pack would shoot you off the side of the ledge, only allowing you to touch the ground after it had mildly disengaged its thrust. This is actually not the case. As you can see here, the thruster pack simply takes your normal trajectory angle that you're going to fall anyway, produces that in a slightly more exaggerated and speedy form. It just takes your movement angle that you're going to perform and just executes it in a more quick manner. So if I go over to the center of the map here on Haven, right before I fall off this ledge, I want to mention that if I fall off this ledge to bottom middle normally, the fall is kind of floaty or almost anti-gravity-like, and this is the case in most Halo games, because they're characterized by the sense that you're in armor, but time is almost slower for a Spartan. And if I were to use a thruster pack in this scenario, instead of falling very slowly, I'm going to very quickly drop to the bottom of the map and gain traction so I can get away. This is a very useful point to note with a thruster pack, because it allows you to get out of some pretty tight situations. And moving on, there's a concept called strong sighting, which I'm sure some of you are familiar with. It's simply taking your viewpoint and pointing it all the way straight downwards so that it's harder to see your head from behind. That way, when people are actually shooting you, it's harder for them to get the headshot. The thruster pack pulls a very similar maneuver, and that it is while you're thruster packing, as you can see here, your head kind of ducks down. So during that very short period of time, it's harder to headshot you from behind. Another very unique characteristic of the thruster pack is how it works going up a lift. Now we will have some map-specific lift jumps at the end of the video, but just for now, get your eyes used to how it looked normally going up this lift on Haven. And then, watch how I thruster pack back into the lift as I'm going up it, delaying my entry into the top of the map. Loosely speaking, it is safe to say that the thruster pack allows you to cancel the effect of a lift for a temporary period of time. If there's an open position like this, you can even thrust your pack out of the lift as you're going up it. An extremely minor detail, grenades thrown right before you thrust your pack do go along their original thrown trajectory. This allows for a quick getaway from the original explosion radius of your grenade. Now, many of you are probably already aware that when you ninja or backsmack an enemy player, you are standing in front of them while the enemy player is charging from behind. You jump over the enemy player's head and hit them for the instant kill. You can predict this to more longer ranges with a thruster pack as shown here, jumping over their head and hitting them from behind. While the timing of this advanced maneuver is touchy and hard to nail down without practice, it is safer than a normal ninja because it doesn't allow the enemy player to approach you as closely from behind. A slightly more practical way to use a thruster pack in combination with a melee is to melee an enemy player and then thruster pack away from them. Now, the example you're seeing here is the most basic form of doing this, simply thruster packing directly back from the enemy player after committing to the melee. Now, a better way to pull this off is to melee the enemy player and thruster pack off to the left or right, making the enemy player turn towards you and possibly disorienting them a small amount. However, the absolute best way to pull this off is to melee the enemy player and literally thruster pack past them so that they have to turn around the full 180 degrees. So let's look at this from the perspective of the enemy player meleeing me. You can see that when they commit to the melee and then thruster pack, I have to turn towards them. This is rather disorienting, but the most disorienting thing is, again, when the enemy player melees me and thruster packs all the way past me, making me turn all the way around. By that time, you can see that the enemy player is already facing me and could have easily gotten the kill. It is worth noting that if you thruster pack too early while you're meleeing, you can actually cancel your melee and it will not land on the enemy player. So my final very important tip before we move on to actual matchmaking examples using the thruster pack is that if you know the weapons in Halo 4 well enough, you can understand when to dodge them with the thruster pack, such as the bolt shot and railgun shown here. If you know the timing of them, you can use your audio and visual cues to determine when they're about to fire. Thruster packing at the correct moment could literally save your life. Also, against close range weapons like the scattershot and the sword, it's very useful with the thruster pack, dodging out of the way, allowing you to preserve a few seconds of life for your teammates to help you or for you to get the kill. We're not showing examples of dodging grenades or high impact radius explosions from the things like the rocket launcher here because we want to save those for actual matchmaking examples, but you should ingrain these things in your mind because they're all crucial to what I'm about to show you. So let's move on to part two. Kicking off our matchmaking examples, we have a Captain Flag game on Ragnarok, 5v5. Choosing my infinite sprint mobility loadout, I'm going to lift out the front of my base. But remember how I did previously in this film, thruster packing as I'm going for the Spartan laser, which would only slow me down. Notice here how I'm going to thruster pack right after grabbing it, and it actually allows me to get away from this sniper who sniped me in the body from their base. So let's slow this down. Pulling out my bolt shot so I'm ready to switch it for the Spartan laser, I'm actually going to move to the left, cutting off the sight range of the enemy base with this rock so he can't snipe me straight off. I'm going to go in from the side, grab the Spartan laser and thruster pack, and as you can see, my head is on a different angle so he gets only a snipe on my body, and because I used a thruster pack, he wasn't able to get a second shot because I wasn't in his view sight range. Starting off at the beginning of another Capture the Flag match, except this time on the map Dispatch. I'm going to be sprinting top middle for the overshield off the start of the game. Pausing here, I do want to mention an enemy player's position just above the overshield, the red flag defend icon, and the sniper rifle icon. You can see a blue player is sprinting and jumping top middle for the overshield just like I am. And he's almost the same position I am, really. Like, we're equally close to the overshield. But I want to show you how he doesn't use a thruster pack. I, right here, I'm going to thruster pack straight at the overshield, cutting my time to the overshield off by a few milliseconds. He, on the other hand, I want you to watch him very, very closely, as he's going to end up sprinting, and he's going to have to turn his Spartan viewpoint, and the momentum of his sprint is not going to allow him to turn fast enough to grab the overshield. As you can see here, the clip plays out exactly as I said. I'm gonna grab this overshield a few half seconds before this guy turns towards them. He's gonna try to land a melee on me. It's not gonna register because the overshield grants you 2-3 seconds of invincibility. You're gonna be able to kill off this guy, and I'm gonna sprint for the enemy base to try to grab their flag. No need to thruster pack here, as that only slows me down. Yet another example of grabbing an overshield, except this time in the middle of an Adrift Team Infinity Slayer game. I kill this guy in the attic, notice the overshield spawn top middle and sprint for it, but the enemy player has the same idea, so I cut him off with a thruster pack, and I'm able to get the overshield half a second before he does, while my teammate cleans him up and I get the assist. Now, as I come out of this attic here, you can see the overshield has spawned, and I notice this enemy player in a dead sprint for it. If I don't thruster pack here, there's no way I'm going to make it to the overshield. Now, I did not have to actually turn my player POV, like you see here, towards the overshield before I thruster pack. But if I hadn't thruster packed, like I said, I wouldn't have gotten it. The problem is, this enemy player, if he had been more aware and more timely with his maneuvers, might have been able to melee me from behind and instantly kill me. Thankfully, he's not aware, maybe even didn't even see me, and my teammate's able to clean him up, and I'm able to get away with a mostly intact overshield. I need to pause here and mention to less experienced viewers that the following clips do contain me teabagging or meleeing bodies or shooting bodies, and this is specifically after I ninja or backsmack a player using my thruster pack. Normally my policy is to not do this type of thing in matchmaking because it is rude and inconsiderate, but I would like to warn those viewers out there who don't like it that the following few clips do contain such material. Now the next three clips are simply three ninjas against guest players, not very impressive, and some of them are from the early Halo 4 days. But I want you to notice how I'm going to use my thruster pack, not necessarily in the ninja, but right here to actually go away from the person and fake away from the person to get the ninja. You can see via these clips that it's very interesting how you can use your thruster pack in ninjas, not necessarily to get the ninja, but to fake away from the person and then set up a ninja around a corner somewhere else. And even as you can see in this third clip, almost out in the open, you can get people to follow you, as you see this guy is going to spawn behind me on this ramp that I just passed right here on my right. He's going to spawn behind me, he's going to run at me, and I'm going to thruster pack forward to fake away from him and then set up the air assassination. So moving on to some more thruster pack ninja slash backsmack clips where I actually use the thruster pack in the ninja. I'm going to sprint into shotgun tunnel here on Settler in Big Team Infinity Slayer, and I'm going to actually use my thruster pack, jump the thruster pack over this guy, and melee him from behind for the instant takedown. So let's slow this clip down. So as I enter shotgun tunnel, I'm completely unaware of this little opening to my right where a player is hiding. And this player is actually going to charge at me from behind, as you're going to see on my radar as I just pass him. I'm going to pull out my bolt shot, but I see this overshield carrier jump in front of me. So I quickly notice my radar, jump, and thruster pack backwards. But this guy with the overshield is going to be facing his back towards me, so I'm going to be able to melee him in the back for the instant kill. But someone has an overshield, they're still vulnerable from behind to an instant melee kill. And as you can see here, I get mauled by three players, but taking on the overshield carrier was a really good play and worthy of that push. Here we have some more Big Team Infinity Slayer, except this time on the map Ragnarok. I see the Spartan laser, so I'm going to kind of rashly charge out towards it, and I end up being shot from behind by this player who just came out of their crack rock towards machine gun turret. So I'm going to get right here, call on my overshield, sprint towards it, pick up the overshield, thruster pack forward, jump, and melee this guy from behind for the ninja assassination. So let's slow this down. As I take some very temporary cover behind this rock, I'm going to reload my light rifle, then call down my overshield right in front of me. This enemy player is going to charge, but before he can really get to me, I'm going to charge out, grab the overshield. And what's critical right here is what I do after I grab it. I'm going to jump and thruster pack over his head while turning to the right so that now I'm facing him. You can see he doesn't know where I am. I'm going to get the easy melee ninja backsmack assassination on him for the beatdown. In a game of team doubles in the map Haven, my teammate pushes out a little bit rashly, gets assassinated. This guy drops. I have a railgun, so I'm going to try to drop down and take him out. Didn't realize this enemy player actually had a saw. Missed my railgun. Going to give him some nasty shots with my battle rifle, and then use my thruster pack to jetpack backwards and ninja assassinate the guy dropping down on me from behind. So let's watch this clip in slow motion. Now, as I begin to fight this enemy player, you should notice that on my radar, his teammate has lifted top center behind me and is actually going to drop down on me as I finish this guy off with some solid headshots. I'm going to slightly fake forward. this enemy player is going to drop down behind me, and I'm going to jump thruster pack behind him and get a dirty ninja backsmack assassination. Moving on to my last ninja, and probably my dirtiest one in the early days of Halo 4, playing some Team Infinity Slayer on the drift. See this overshield guy, thruster pack away from him because I know I'm going to die. I'm going to end up letting my thruster pack regenerate, bait him into the lift, use my thruster pack again to air assassinate him. Now it is very important to watch this clip in slow motion because there are not just one, but two thruster pack maneuvers I make during this clip. So let's really slow this down and give this some analytical thoughts. I see this guy on my radar, don't know he has an overshield, but I'm actually going to throw a grenade right here and try to pre-nade him as he comes around the corner. It's a little bit too early of a grenade though as he comes around the corner. I see his own overshield, so I'm going to get as many shots into him as possible before backing up with the thruster pack. Notice how I'm going to thruster pack right before my shields go dead so he cannot get the headshot. Then I'm going to drop immediately after, but I want you to notice here just how fast the thruster pack actually regenerates its charge. I can use it very soon after I used it once before. So this guy drops down behind me. I bait him into the lift. I'm going to hold my left movement analog stick down and to the left as I thruster pack cancel back into the lift, get behind him as he comes up and air assassinate him for an epic ninja. So guys, the next few thruster pack clips are going to come at you pretty fast and furious. We're going to be going over the timing of your thruster pack in relation to how much shields you have. The very close thing you need to pay attention to is the amount of shields I have at the top of my screen in comparison to the timing of when I thruster pack. We're going to start with some bad examples of this and then move on up to some more solid examples where I stay alive. Starting off the game of Dominion on Exile, capture you base, charge out here with my assault rifle, get some shots on these players before being grenaded. And you can see I stayed out in the open way too long here, and I could have easily died. And this same situation on Settler, I see the enemy players have our flag, run out of shotgun tunnel, and end up being shot from both the ridge and their base. And then I turn and thrust a pack, luckily getting away and surviving, but just thruster packing way too late in general. I could have easily died in this situation. Right here is a pretty good maneuver on my part. I saw this guy, then I see the Mantis shooting me, and decide to thruster pack out of the way, making the Mantis focus on my teammates. I'm able to curve back around here, regain my shield, pump a lot more saw shots into this guy with some more grenades, and I'm able to get the assist on the Mantis by taking out all his shields so my teammate can take him out with the Spartan laser. Moving on to a respawn on Capture the Flag, Lombo, I'm pushing up snow ramp to be base, get shot by this guy and then back down, but again a little too late. I could have backed down earlier and let my teammate just handle that second guy as soon as I saw my shields were about to go dead. I'm again on Lombo trying to push up the top middle in the same game of Capture the Flag. I'm going to get shot from some random angles here and going to thruster pack, but a little too late. I could have easily been killed if that guy had been aiming at my head. Top middle on Ragnarok, we're playing a game of Capture the Flag, and I get this guy, get sniped in the body, and then thruster pack to the side. A good example of using the thruster against a sniper so he can't kill you off. This is an example on Wreckage. Getting better, we're getting to the better clips now. I thruster pack to the left here to avoid that second guy from killing me and get the kill. Once again, on Lombo, this clip is the most borderline clip between good and bad that I could find. Literally, I can't determine whether this clip is good or bad because I thruster pack literally in between when I should have. Moving on to Wreckage, this is a much, much better example. You're going to see me thruster pack right before my shields go dead. So it's impossible for this guy to get a headshot, and you're going to see me almost do the same thing a second time in the same clip right here, where I'm shooting this guy, and the same guy DMRs me from top center, and you're going to see me thruster pack to the left here to avoid him right before my shields go dead, and that's what you want to be doing. If the guy gets the headshot, it's super easy for him to clean you up when you have no shields. So right here you can see I'm shooting this guy, jump off, this guy gets some really solid shots at me as I'm firing, but look at my shield, how they have a sliver shield left and are taken away by this guy's grenade. Get a really clutch peak scoped headshot there. Now top mid on Ragnarok again. We have me shooting this enemy player, then backing down with a sliver shield left, call him out to my teammate who's to my right. This guy gets one shot, tries to pull up his bubble shield, and we end up taking him out. I pop into the bubble shield and look at our flag, which just got taken by the enemy team. Now on a drift, I do end up taking out Mojo Walker here with my help from my teammate. This guy's in our attic. I don't see him. Peek out the doorway, and this guy ends up shooting me back down and let my teammate sneak up from behind him in the attic and take him out for the assist that you can see on my screen right there. Moving on to an example on Complex. This is a great example of backing up early, even though I didn't know how much fire I was going to be hit by. I try to overextend for this kill, back up way too early because I realize I am overextended, and then try to regain my shield. I'm able to pop out here and get the kill. It is really important to back up earlier than you might think, because you never know how many people you're going to be shot by. Again, on the DLC map Monolith, I get a pretty nice triple kill here, but unfortunately I run out of battery from my beam rifle and I try to get the overkill, and so I'm going to back up here just before my shields go dead and see the three shots in front of me as this guy misses me with his three-shot burst. It's just so important to thrush back at the correct moment, as you can see here. So guys, those are those examples of thrush backing at the correct moment. Now let's move on to some other examples. Delving into a few odds and ends thruster pack examples, we go into the pit where I'm on training and I get shot at by a bunch of people, but I'm going to use this bridge as my shields go dead to block my head from their viewpoint, thruster pack, and turn to the left so I can sprint away around this corner and survive. On Monolith again, Team Infinity Slayer, I accidentally pick up an assault rifle trying to get a sticky detonator and end up pouring most of my clip into this enemy overshield carrier. Seeing that he's shooting my teammate, I trade places with my weak teammate under this beam, but get surprised by the enemy overshield carrier, so I use my thrust attack to jet away and allow my teammate with the sticky det to kill him from behind so I get the assist. Holding the enemy shotgun cave on the map Ragnarok, I see this enemy player and he doesn't charge through the cave like I expect, instead going towards their water lift front exit. I shoot him, but he backs in into the water and then decides to peek out again, allowing me to get even more shots on him. So I decide to overextend for this kill, but I end up being shot from their crack rocks, so I back up the thruster pack, faking back into this cave so that they lose their sight range on me, and then I go ahead and run back to Pelican to stay alive. Top middle on the map Vortex, I see this guy lift over, but he pre-names me around the corner as I jumps out, so just playing it safe, I'm going to thrust the pack back to top middle where my teammates are to stay alive and get support from them. We have another thruster pack clip coming up right here on Vortex. I'm going to lift top middle for my 10% battery sword, and I'm going to charge these players and get a kill, but I don't realize how many of them there are because there's no radar. So I get one kill, then thruster pack into the center where the lift is so that I can drop down and stay alive beside the lift, then lift back up and kill the guy hard light shielding. Lifting up one of the center lifts on Lombo, I'm going to see a bunch of people top middle in the hill, get some shots off before I get really weak. A bunch of grenades come my way, so I thruster pack cancel back into the lift to avoid these grenade splash damage. In a game of team doubles on Pitfall, my teammate and I are kind of trapping Green Hall. He has the rockets. An enemy player charges us in Green Hall with grenades. Thruster pack cancel out of that hall. My teammate cleans up that guy with a rocket. You can see that guy in sword has a sniper, snipes my teammate. I'm going to try to regain the rockets. Use my thruster pack to duck underneath the sniper bullet as this guy tries to pick me off from sword. The enemy sniper then tries to shoot the fusion coils just to my left, exploding them and weakening my shields, but I'm still able to get away with those three rockets and stay alive for my teammate to come back to me for support. In another game of Infinity Devils, this time on the map Haven, I charge top Mohawk and try to kill this player, but this guy jumps out while I'm reloading, so I decide to back up and thrust a pack perfectly so that the last two bullets of this three-shot BR burst hit the very top of my back and not my head. The only reason I stayed alive in this situation was because I thrust a pack at the exact perfect moment. Moving on to some more close range slash splash damage thruster pack examples. This guy charges me around the corner. I melee him, get the BR headshot, and thrust a pack away from his last suicidal grenade. Moving on to another rather lengthy example on the map Pitfall. I respawn in this game of Ricochet. Look training to see a guy shooting our ball carrier. Really focused on him. Receive a lot of fire from the left though, so I'm going to thrust a pack forward to go off this ledge and stay alive. Now, I'm going to try to push long haul a little bit with some grenades and some BR fire, but eventually I'm going to watch this grenade bank off a wall to my left, and I'm going to back down from that grenade to stay alive even further. So I decide to charge green box with my teammate here, and here's an excellent example of using the melee plus the thrust pack, putting three shots into this guy, meleeing him, thrust packing back in the green box to stay alive, and provides further support fire for my teammate. So I'm charging the newly spawned rockets, and I see this guy pick up the rockets, and he has a jetpack. So he jetpacks up in the air. I realize he's about to fire a rocket, jump and thruster pack backwards, and his rocket takes out all my shields, but I get away just in time to avoid death and stay alive. A little more humorous, but still an effective example of the thruster pack, this guy gains an overshield during the last stand phase on Dominion as we capture all the bases. He charges me with an incineration cannon, but I thruster pack to the right, and he ends up just going straight forward into this rock and incinerating cannon himself with an overshield. I actually get the incineration cannon after that, and we end up winning the game. Pretty crazy. So moving into some really close range examples, we're going to see an example of me meleeing a player and thruster packing directly afterwards, even though it doesn't really have any effect because this player didn't throw a grenade or anything. And then we're also going to see me use my thruster pack during my bolt shot's cooldown period to allow me to thruster pack, stay alive, and shoot a second bolt shot, charge shot into this guy for the double kill. And we see a kind of similar scenario here on Exile Lockdown, a version of Dominion where there's only one base. I'm kind of jumping in to be base and then get hit by a grenade, so I'm going to thruster pack off and try to stay alive. A little late thruster packing there. You're going to see me use the same maneuver with the bolt shot to stay alive and get this second kill for the double kill, avoiding that first grenade, but unfortunately getting stuck as I get the double kill. Now later on in another game of Lockdown, I actually charge this center base, I'm capturing it. And then just as I stop capturing, I look to my left and find these two enemy players here. And I want you to notice how I use the thruster pack to stay alive by jetting away from this guy so he can't get the melee. And this is another very similar example. As you see, this guy charges me on my right and I land a melee on him, thruster pack away, and land a second melee, and he misses his melee. Let's slow that down because that happened really fast. You can see this guy charges from my right in my radar. I'm going to back up, land a melee on him, thruster pack behind him. He misses his melee because he doesn't know where I am. And I'm able to punch him. That's a really good example of using the thruster pack in combination with a melee. And as we see here on Lombo, a very similar thing where I surprise a player almost, melee him, then come out of the melee animation, shooting him in the head for that kill. Now, this next example is also a decent example. I do miss this railgun shot here, but I make up for it by thruster packing to the left, so this guy misses his melee, and I'm able to double melee him to get this kill. Now I have two clips to back next that are kind of miscellaneous. This was on some team multi-team on Haven, and you're actually going to see me take out the enemy green team twice here, as this enemy green player does have the overshield. I get a little bit of help from my teammate, but right here you're going to see me take out both these players twice. Using my thruster pack expertly after cleaning up this player, I'm going to dodge this bolt shot, charge shot that this guy was about to nail me with. Gonna kill both of them. They spawn on top of me, end up expertly out VRing this player, and then I'm gonna thruster pack to stay alive, pulling out my bolt shot. I'm gonna kill this second player yet again. I'm killing both of the enemy green team off twice. It's really impressive. Now I want to pause here and mention something during this clip that's kind of also miscellaneous. A lot of these things I'm showing you, I'm not showing you in completion. For example, I'm not showing you how to dodge every single weapon or every single encounter or every single vehicle. I'm simply planting the idea in your mind for you to then come up with your own ways to use the thruster pack in specific scenario. I'm just showing you some of my best moments, not all the possible uses. I can't, that would be impossible. Nice. Now moving on to some vehicle clips where I dodge vehicles. Just gonna have three here shortly. Two using the ghost right here, you can see I just dodge the ghost really fast here and dodge it from scattering me. Actually, we're going to have three clips after this one, so this is the second one. Going to dodge another ghost just trying to splatter me again and jump away here. Moving on to a clip on Harvest, we're going to have the same scenario where I kind of committed to a jump rashly and then thruster pack out to stay away from that. And then you're going to see me use the thruster pack to dodge this Banshee bomb. We're actually going to slow this clip down to slow motion right as the Banshee fires this Banshee bomb, and I'm going to dodge to the right behind this box. Away. This is just a few examples to plant these ideas in your mind of how to use the thruster pack. But anyway, now we're actually going to move into some clips on how to use the thruster pack with the flag and objective items. Now everyone, please pay very close attention because I'm only going to slow this part of the thruster pack guide down once, and that is grabbing objectives while thruster packing. If you thruster pack right as you grab an objective, the flag will glitch under your primary weapon as you see here for about half a second or so, as you thrust your pack with the objective. Normally, you cannot use your armor ability while holding the objective, but you can thrust your pack right as you grab the objective. And this is the same with the oddball ball and with the ricochet ball as well. You can see I also can thrust your pack backwards or really in any direction with the objective, as you saw there by that clip as I strong side out of this base trying to stay alive. Now, a lot of these examples are on Settler, but that's just because I had a good game on Settler and had some really good examples of how to grab the flag using the thruster pack. It really confuses the enemy team when you do this, as you can see here, and you can get some really clutch plays. I'm able to get some really good flag pulls. And I just want to say that grabbing an oddball or any other objective besides the flag is more difficult if you want to combine it with the thruster pack. For whatever reason, grabbing the flag with your thruster pack seems slightly easier. You have a slightly larger window of opportunity to thruster pack. You can even thruster pack right before you grab the flag, like I do here. I just thruster pack before I grab the flag and thruster pack sort of into the flag, and that will work as well if you really want to do that. It allows you to really get away, and it looks really cool when you do it, and it really is very useful. This is the last example we have here. Jumping into the front of the enemy base. This is the jump you should always use in Ragnarok, not going to the bottom of the enemy base. Get a flag assassination, and this guy just sitting here sniping. I thought that was pretty cool to lift out of the base here. I'm going to turn on and get a kill with my pistol. Now, I want to also speak to combination movements, and what you're about to see, I'm just going to kind of throw you in here, a game on dispatch, capture the flag. You can combine the thruster pack with a speed boost, plus things like fast reloading and, you know, flag grabbing. As you can see right here, the animation where I jet away with the flag is so much longer. You'll see just yet another example right here. And I don't want to really go over this too much, because as you gain experience with using the thrust pack, like I said, you will understand how to use it more effectively. You'll understand, oh wow, I can get away with things like this. Like after I kill this guy who kills himself with the fuel rod, I'm going to look around for a Spartan laser, because I know he had a Spartan laser. But then, oh my gosh, I'm getting shot from their base, and I'm going to jetpack just straight over, or thruster pack straight over the hill to stay alive. You'll pick up on various little things like that, and it's really nice. I can't tell you the number of clips I have. There's just too many to really even count. So I'm just kind of showing you the best ones, but clips like the ones you're seeing right now. I thruster pack away here to allow my teammate to get this guy weak so I can get this guy and get the triple kill. Well, I actually get a killtrocity here, but I'm going to cut away because I want to save that clip for more appropriate video. And right here, I have a speed boost with a DMR on complex and a shotgun in my back pocket. I'm going to charge out of this base, shotgun this guy, go to the side and get the last two kills with my shotgun precariously to end the game with an overkill. Now, moving on even further, we have our second to last clip here again on complex. Now, I want to point out something. Watch my radar closely as I'm going to get away from this guy. As he almost shoots me in the back and almost kills me. I'm going to call down my speed boost. A lot of players would just rush in here and try to kill this guy without really waiting this guy to my right. But instead, I'm going to thruster pack away and stay alive, letting my teammate run in there and get the wingman for the distraction. That's really how you want to be using the thruster pack, is to stay alive, not necessarily be 100% offensive. Now, right here is a familiar clip. A lot of you are going to be like, oh, I may have seen this clip before. You may have seen several of these clips before, and that's okay. You're going to notice, okay, this guy, we've already seen this melee, you know, this double melee here. This clip is the last clip I'm going to show you of my matchmaking examples, and it's just simply, it's an extremely good example of the stuff you're able to get away with while using the thruster pack away from this grenade, literally almost saving my life here. I get the first railgun kill in this multi-kill here, throw a second grenade, get the double kill, have some really solid VR shots on this guy to get the triple kill, pick up the beam rifle for the overkill and then the kill-tacular. Then I use the thruster pack again to stay alive from this guy who spawns to my left. Gonna get behind this rock, then I'm going to drop down into this bottom cave, which a lot of people don't know about in Vortex, call down my speed boost, and use the thruster pack again in just a little bit here after I get a sick snapshot on this guy lifting up. This guy surprises me, a thruster pack away to my left. This guy behind me actually has a speed boost, believe it or not. I saw it in theater mode. And you can see all the dots on my radar, just unbelievable. I'm going to thruster pack away, try to get away from these people. They're shooting me in the back like crazy. I back up and I'm going to literally just wait for them to come to me. And it works out really, really well here, as you can see, as I do miss a few shots, but I'm going to end up getting this overkill and taking out the enemy team sniper. Just a really good job for the Running Riot. But the clip doesn't end here. As I kind of fake back into this base, I'm protecting my teammates in the goshawk here. I'm going to go back into this base, and then I'm going to come back out because this guy kind of charges me, and I lose my speed boost here. But another excellent example of using my thruster pack timed with a melee so that it fakes out the enemy player. Now I'm going to call down another speed boost here. Two speed boosts in a row, just really good job on my part. Now I know my teammate is battling this mantis, so I'm going to fake back, acting like I'm not there, and then I'm going to rush in at the mantis, fake the mantis into stomping, rush behind the mantis as it stomps. It's locked into the animation. I hijack the mantis. The guy comes out of the mantis, and then I'm able to take him out. So let's move on now to part three of the video. So part three of this video will be the shortest part of all three parts. We're just going to show you some map jumps really quickly at the end here to kind of spur your imagination as to what you can do with a thruster pack and what you can get away with. Here we have a kind of interesting jump to start us off on Haven, but I'm going to show a follow-up to this jump that I just showed, and that is you can actually thruster pack to the left as I just did, but actually jump on this little ledge and hop over. It's really interesting. I'm going to shoot the ledge right where you can jump. Kind of interesting jump you can make here. Now, I'm just jumping right here onto this kind of same ledge that I'm jumping and thrust backing to top middle. Now, if you actually miss that jump while you're practicing in custom games, I'd recommend you can just sort of thrust your pack away and avoid death here by falling to this little hole right there. Now, these are kind of more getting to more slightly more advanced jumps. Then we have these jumps where you kind of go off the left and right of the bottom street lifts, and you can see I can not only make it onto the bottom of the street, but I can also make it to the top middle area as well, which is a really useful sort of counter jump. Now the following jump is also kind of basic. It's on the left hand side. We're just going over these jumps to see how you do them. Now the following jump you're about to see is pretty darn advanced, and it took me a while to get the timing down. You need to be turning towards where you're going to thrust your pack. So always press forward and sprint into this lift, turn where you want to thruster pack while still holding forward on your movement stick, and press the armor ability button. There's a lot of useful jumps like the one you're about to see. You're going to want to turn into the smallest angle towards the window and then jump into the window. Notice how I'm not turning. I can also look straight down if I want to and turn and then thruster pack straight into the window. It really just takes practice. A lot of these jumps are not that difficult as long as you just have done them over and over again. You can see how I almost miss or how I almost hit the side of the ledge, but I know how to do the jump, so I can do it almost every time. Now, I want you to see right here how I almost miss the ledge and then actually get into the window. I'm going to jump down and show you a little alternative way to practice. Just back into the lift. You don't necessarily have to sprint to make this jump. Just back into the lift. It's all about the timing of your thruster pack. So I hope that gives you guys some ideas on how to make some of these jumps on Haven. Now let's move on to the map Solace. I actually start this off from the beginning of the game so that I can actually show you which base I spawn in. I spawn in non-forest base or open base. Go around to the center here, and this beam in the center of the map actually doesn't kill you, it's actually just a lift. So all I'm going to do is jump and sprint and try to thruster pack through the very center of the beam right before I touch the beam. And you just need to experiment with around in custom games to figure this out. But if I try to jump into the other base, as shown here, I actually end up jumping through it and hitting something in the roof, which is really unfortunate because that side has it and the other side doesn't. So you can only jump into one base through the beam, which is really, really unfortunate. I wish that was not the case. But I really like these kind of unique skill jumps. I think they're pretty cool. And they're just neat things you can do with the thruster pack. So I hope this kind of piques your interest. You can also use it to jump from the sides. It doesn't shoot you off the map, surprisingly. I thought that's what it would do when I first tried to do these jumps. Again, I'm just sprinting, jumping, and right before I touch the beam, I'm thruster packing through the center of the beam while just holding forward on my movement stick. Now right here is kind of a unique thing. You can jump into the beam and it carries you to the top, but I thruster pack back into the beam to carry me even farther, which is really nice. Just run around in custom games, experiment with it. It's a great thing to do to pass the time, for sure. Spawning in our base at the beginning of the Meltdown game, I'm going to teleport out to our bunker in the last few clips we have, and there's this lift outside the bunker on both sides of the map that will just kind of loftily shoot you into the center of the map near the entrance to the cave. But if you jump into this lift and thruster pack right as you enter the lift, you'll shoot upwards like this, and it's really interesting lift because many of the lifts in the game don't do this. Some of the lifts on Exile, They just don't have this kind of buoyancy to them. Now, you can see if I touched the pack too late there, I didn't actually shoot all the way up. But experiment, guys. I want to sort of leave this video kind of open-ended at the end. I'm going to have a few thoughts, but I do want to impress upon you that you have to experiment with this type of thing to get good with it. I really hope that's where I leave you and that you also learn something from this video. But as it is, this is the end of the video, but if you want to stick around for my thoughts on the thruster pack, feel free. But in the meantime, like and subscribe, and I'll see you on my next capture. So guys, for those of you still around, I do want to end this video by thanking you for everything and for subscribing, for being so kind and nice in the comments, and for giving me feedback when I do something wrong, or if there's something you don't quite agree with, or something I should have added. Something I do want to point out, this is a video, and I feel I really need to explain this to those of you viewers that are consistent and that watch all my videos to the end of the video, is that many of you were probably under the impression that this video would be released a lot earlier than it was, and you were absolutely correct. And I want to apologize. Once again, I'll explain that when I originally created this video, I was 30 minutes into the video. I had created more than half of it when suddenly my computer decided to crap on me and delete the project file. And unfortunately, I do know that this was not my fault. It was not something that I could have prevented. It was just a random glitch that occurred. A few days later, an update came out that fixed this bug, and it has never occurred to me again, thankfully. And it also taught me to constantly back up my computer, which I'm doing every other day, if not more than that, to make sure that I don't lose any of these precious videos. As it is, this video took me an extraordinarily long time to create, and only just recording the clips that I actually had. All of these clips are me in matchmaking, which is kind of ridiculous when you think about it. I do have over 100,000 kills in Halo 4 matchmaking. I just hit that number, so that's nice because I do have a lot of gameplay to pull from, but I only recently got my capture card like less than a year ago. So that what you're seeing is the product of me just spending a huge amount of time spent to create one video to really, really, really go in-depth on one specific portion of the game. This type of video is what I like doing, and I intend to do these types of videos, not necessarily the length. I'll try to make it shorter than this and more formal and stuff, but for other games as well. Other games like the Master Chief Collection, Destiny, Halo 5 Guardians, the beta for Destiny and Halo 5 Guardians, things of that nature. I really want to continue doing that for things that are related to or directly related to Halo. And I hope that you guys want to see more of that and that you're excited. As it is, I don't think I'll be creating any more as lengthy videos as this one for Halo 4 specifically until we move on to the Master Chief Collection. But until the Master Chief Collection comes out, while I will be playing one or two other games, I'll be consistently streaming Halo 4 gameplay. You can check that out in the description, and Destiny gameplay as well, with the Destiny beta coming out. But I will also just be really looking forward to the expansion of my channel into these areas and making videos that I hope you guys will enjoy. I'm not going to say what they are simply because I don't want to bring your hopes up like I did with this video and then have you later be disappointed. But as it is, thank you guys for watching. This has been Genesis Rider, and I'll see you guys in the next capture or whatever I am recording. Peace. Victory.